is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Marty in Worcester, Mass. Hey, Marty, what's going on?
Hi, Mr. O'Brien. Got a quick little thing here.
Yeah?
It's called patience and perseverance.
Okay.
Patience. I heard of God is yelling, the magic silent word, and methinks I must be smelling pokey money round the world. Perseverance. When markets roil like stormy seas, good traders seek safe port. In financial times like these, you need Tom O'Brien's gold report.
You had too much money. Man, that is so cool. But listen, man, I really appreciate that.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. This quote is by Bernard Berenson. Miracles happen to those who believe in them. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. The Dow Industrial's down 166. You get the NASDAQ off 30. S&Ps are down 16. Gold contract down $9.30, trading at $1,085 an ounce. Silver down 3 cents at $14.44 an ounce. Platinum down $22 at $9.60 an ounce. Copper's flat at $2.40 a pound. Light sweet crude getting smoked, down $1.79 at $45.33 a barrel. But, you know, we'll go over the oil market. Bottom line, it looks like this oil is going to crack the 42, and 35 is game inside oil. King bonds, 10-year up 12 ticks. Sorry, folks, excuse me. At 127.26. That is with wide price spread volume last week, follow through this week. 30-year up almost 2 points. We're up 1.22 ticks at 157.20. Bonds, folks, have given the most consistent information that they want higher price, lower yield. That gives us markets at lower price. King dollar. King dollar up 171 ticks at 97.61. Dollar hasn't been able to hold higher price. Each and every time it tries to get up into higher price, it's getting sold off. Euro down 35 at 109.49, and the yen up 7 at 123.90. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. I know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. If we go over to the S&P first, folks, what you're going to see is this. Is that we take a look at the SPY. The SPY is trading out at 208.98. You're off $1.53. You get some price spread going, and we get a little volume, nothing heavy. We had hit a high out here on Friday with 103 million. It failed on price, failed on volume, all of the above. We're doing 76 million right now. You're at 209.01, which gets you right into the trading day from the 28th of July. That's saying we're going to go to the bottom once again. We'll see how it handles the 206.26 area. Bottom line is that inside the NYSE, you really don't have a lot of volume. Doesn't mean it won't pick up in the next hour, but there's really not a lot of volume. Inside the NASDAQ, though, you have the juice. The NASDAQ has had the juice, continues to have the juice as it's running into lower price. We go look at the QQQs. The Qs right now are trading at 111.26. And we have done 18 million shares. The lowest swing point on the Qs happens to be right at the bottom of the bar that we're trading at, and we're already into that bar. So that's telling us that the Qs are going to be down at that bottom quicker than the SPYs. And inside the NDX 100, which you do have putting some pressure on the NDX 100 out here, is Staples. Staples is down 61 cents. You got Mattel off 85. SWKS. Skyworks is down $3, and you had Whole Foods down 106. Now, what's really intriguing is that I just read you the laggards inside there. And that is not even counting Apple. And Apple is putting some heavy pressure on the NDX 100 as well as the S&Ps. Apple's down 264. And what you're going to see with Apple, Apple's breaking lower with volume. And what you do have is that this is the first time in about 18 months. Actually, it's longer than that. This is the first time, and let's see, I would say that has broken its 200-day moving average. This sideways move by Apple has been pretty, since September of 2013. So you broke the 200-day, and you broke it with conviction, by the way. So what you will see tomorrow in Apple, that's going to appear on many boxes tonight, you're going to see a lot more selling pressure on Apple just because of the fact that 200-day moving average does mean, quite a bit, not to, to a lot of funds, that's for sure. There's no doubt about that. Small caps. What do we have with the small caps? We go take a look at the IWM. What we have with the small caps, now the small caps have been the weakest ETF structure. When we take a look at the NASDAQ, the Dow, the S&P, and then the Russell 2000. We're backing down today. 25 million shares. Your high volume swing point that had already broken the consolidation we've been in, that was established out here on the 28th, is going to get tested again. Now, the high of that area is 121.81, and that's where we're at right now, at 121.88. So the danger is closing right at these particular levels. Why? Because the indices wake up tomorrow morning, they'll have more power as they go into those price points. Gold, let's go take a look at the gold contract. What's intriguing here about the gold contract, by the way, you have it down, gold contract right now is down 950. With that being said though, 130, the pit closes, folks. Bottom line is that you had that contract was flat at 150. At 14, 20 hours, you got an acceleration on the way down, light volume. You came down with 3,600 contracts. Well, the 3,600 contracts is coming into 8,500 contracts. So bottom line is that, yeah, you get someone that sold it down, but in the pit, they couldn't get that baby down. Now, let's go over to King Dollar. What do we have with King Dollar? King Dollar is just the opposite. King Dollar, on a continual basis, has not been able to hold higher price. We take a look at this. King Dollar today has 29,000 contracts. The high of today is 97.69. That baby, when we take a look at it, the last swing high out here was established on the 20th of July. That swing high was 98.31. You came off that high with volume. Friday, we came down, we hit a low of 96.37 with volume. Today, it tried to get into the highs of Friday, and it couldn't even make the highs of Friday, which is indicating, folks, that the market, the dollar, wants lower price. Now, let's go to good old the bond market. So what do we have with bonds? If we take a look at the TLT, is the 20-plus year bond fund. You stay right there. We'll bisect and dissect this baby. Bottom line, folks, bonds want higher price, lower yield. Right now, your 10-year is trading at 2.1 on a 10-year. It's Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We come right back.
Tom O'Brien has just announced a live online workshop taking place Wednesday, August 12th, 6 trades for September. This special event will be open to all subscribers to his daily newsletter, Market Insights. Tom will walk you through 6 trade setups in the market he's identified setting up for September. 2 long positions, 2 short positions, and 2 option trades. New subscribers will also receive a free copy of his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, an $88 value. But we're not done yet. We're also including a Tiger's Den membership as part of all Market Insights subscriptions at no cost as well. You get Tom O'Brien's best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, 30 days of his newsletter, Market Insights, access to his live online workshop, 6 trades for September, and access to the Tiger's Den. This offer is only valid for 2 weeks, so don't miss out. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to Market Insights at the front page of TFNN.com today. In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is off 164. You get the NASDAQ off 32. S&Ps are off 15.5. And, you know, you can expect a bit more selling as we come into this close out here, folks. The turn in the market, you know, this morning was really quick. There's no two ways about that. And when these turns come out and they're quick, fast, and furious, which we had, and on top of that, we should have had window dressing versus window breaking. Bottom line, that's saying you have weakness, underlying weakness in this marketplace, and no doubt we have had that underlying weakness. So let's go over to the bond market. The bond market, folks, has been screaming for a long time that it continues to want higher price, lower yield. As the Fed is turning around saying they're going to raise rates. Bottom line, what does the TLT do? The TLT took out a B point on Friday with volume, has the acceleration up here today. We are at 123.48, and that baby's going to be running up to this 130 level. So bottom line, money is pouring back into the bond market, has continued to pour into the bond market, by the way. But you're going to see more of that. What's going to be intriguing, let's go put this up here. Now, I'm going to put the continuous contract up for a second just to show you what we have happening inside the 30-year. So we take the 30-year. 30-year right now is at 122.57. It's up 122, rather. It's at 157.18. That's now also just taking out the highs that were generated on the 29th of May. Well, guess what? The next stop is 166. And the 166 number is the highs. You know, so if this is the only retracement you're going to have, this is where this gets really wild, folks, okay? Because if we bring this back, what you're going to see, I'm going to bring this back 2 years and show you, I'll bring it back 5 years so you can see the correlation. The correlation inside of this, okay, when we talk about a type of retracement that we had, you had from the lows that were established in December of 2013, you had a 50% retracement in the marketplace, okay? That's a normal retracement in any market that wants to go higher or lower. You know, let's say if you're going down, you can do a 50% retracement on the way back up. You're going up, you do a 50% retracement when you're pulling back. We pulled back with lighter volume. Now the bottom line is that it's going to go test the highs. And guess what? If it takes the highs out with volume, you're going to higher price, which is just absolutely wild. There's no doubt about that it's wild. If we go over to Apple again, you're going to see some dumping on Apple into the close out here. The low out here today in Apple is 117.52. We'll see whether it jams down there. But you do, that is a high volume swing low at those lows today. So there's going to be more selling pressure as we come into those lows. The diamonds, if we take a look here, well, I'll give you the strength versus the weakness inside the Dow Industrials. Inside the Dow, you have Chevron is down 296. Apple is the culprit, down 296. And Big Blue. Big Blue's off 362. Caterpillar falls up at 153. Putting strength inside the Dow. The biggest strength is Coca-Cola, and that's a dog, folks. Coke wants to go lower, but Coca-Cola is up 28 cents. Disney is up 57 cents. And if we do look at Disney, Disney's coming out tomorrow after the market close with their numbers. The Travelers Insurance is up 42 cents and Intel is up 3 cents. Inside the NDX 100, strength versus weakness. The strength is Autodesk. That's up 227. That's a dead cat bounce. That's been down dramatically. You get American Airlines up $1.30. Micron's up 54 cents and Paychex is up 91. Taken away from it. On the way down, you have Staples down 57. Mattel is off 82. SWKS is down 322. And Whole Foods is off 109. If we go over and we take a look at, let's SWKS. Take a look at the Skyworks here and see what we have happening. So Skyworks is trading 92.55. She's going after a swing point. That swing point being 97.44. It has lighter volume, but she's going after it. This was one rocket ship on the way up. It went nonstop from $20 up to the 112. Now what you have... Okay, so, man, this is a trip. So what she's going after, folks, okay, this is just... Each and every one of these equities are going after this. She's going after... You're just going to crack up. The high volume October 2014 swing low. That's what it's going after. That number is 88.25. We'll hit 91.36. That's where she's going. That's where this market wants to go. You know, you have a slow roll that's developing inside the marketplace. You have plenty of equities that have already got into that area. You have some large caps that not only got into that area, just took that area apart like nothing. And then you had a few. Google was one of them. Google was one of the first ones to get into it, and then it rejected it and went to higher price. But when you take a look at the amount of equities that have gone in there that actually have taken that area out and, you know, taken it out with some good juice, this has the probability of the S&P getting down and going into that area goes up dramatically. If we just look at ExxonMobil, Exxon's at 77.98, and, you know, I don't know what's going to basically take this down another 10 points, but that's the way this is, wants to trade right now. And that's not pushing it too far either, because this thing has gone one way from 104 down to 77. But the way this is laid out right now, we put this on a monthly, what you're going to see is that you broke into a much lower trading range. That range is saying, hey, it wants to get down to this August of 2011 swing low, which is 67. Chevron was the saving grace, actually, inside whether you'd be buying ExxonMobil. Because, you know, we got plenty of calls here because you can understand. You know, you get large integrated equities that pay big dividends. What Chevron has been doing is this, is that it's making its way down into that August 2011 area. And guess what? It broke it today. That's the first part. It broke it. So what Chevron wants to do is that Chevron's going to go after the highs of the October 08 low. That's 83.70. And let it go. Don't get in the middle of this thing. Because if we go over and you actually take a look at the oil market, okay, we bring this oil market up right now. CLU5, what you're going to see inside the market is that we've done 340,000 contracts out here today, monster contracts. You broke 300. Oh, man, yeah, it's another ABC down. Okay, so check it out. Let me pull this back, put this on a daily. What you're going to see, you broke a B point today and you broke it with volume. So your A point on this is 54.35. Your B is 46. So you get $8. That sets up, well, that sets up 41. So right now you got an ABC structure down to 41. I believe we got a larger one that's down to 35. But you got a confirmed ABC structure on the way down to 41. What confirmed means, folks, is that you broke a B point, you broke it with volume. So that means the probability that you're going to reach the one-to-one structure goes up. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We come right back. Dow is down 154. Nasdaq's off 30. S&Ps are off 15. We're going to be right back.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
If you're looking for a great opportunity to diversify your financial portfolio, consider the principal-protected MarketSafe CD from EverBank. They've just released the second running of their five-year MarketSafe Power Metal CD, which combines the power of gold, silver, and copper. You get exposure to three valuable metals in one index CD and have the potential to earn up to 45% capped upside payment at maturity if the metals increase in value across annual pricing dates. And should they decrease, no worries. There's zero risk to your deposited principal here, as you still get 100% of it back. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There is no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on the CD. Intrigued yet? The August 17th funding deadline is quickly approaching. So hurry over to everbank.com/TFNN-CD for more information, including important product details and disclosures. Once again, that's everbank.com/TFNN-CD. EverBank is a member FDIC.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's off $1.44, Nasdaq's off 26, S&Ps are off 13, and we go over and let's, there we go. Okay, so let's take a look at a couple equities for some tigers and tigresses out here. The first one will be INVN. Let's take a look. INVN. Okay, so let's see what we got here. INVN. This is, let's see. What do these folks do? Okay, so they do micro electromagnetical gyroscopes for processing consumer electronics. The company offers devices for application and game controllers. Digital still cameras. The low for the year is 1251. The high is 26. And you got a little dead cat bounce going here. I wouldn't be touching this baby. You know, this baby's off the highs of 26. She's going to be, I suspect, trying to back in to where she came off the highs in May of 2013. Let me pull this back. That's a weekly. So what it's trying to do is back into the very lows that were established out here in April of 2013. That's the way that baby is lining up right now. Michael Kors, that baby, you talk about a round trip, man. That's a round trip extraordinaire. That's trading out at $38 right now. And if you take a look at it, what you're going to see is that when it started its run up, it started that run up at $20 going all the way back at December of 2011, makes the run all the way up to 101. And guess what? Now that particular run all the way back looks like larger problems inside that supply chain. That's the way that is shaken out right now. Because what you do get, you know, inside that whole business, folks, that's got to be one of the toughest businesses in the world. Meaning that when things are cool, okay? Bottom line, when people start buying them and they're not cool, and or there's so many knockoffs that everyone seems to have the same thing, well, everyone moves on. That's where that shakes out. If we go take a look at the, let's go take a look at the silver market, SIU5. So silver and platinum got whacked big time. I mean, SIU5. So we take a look at silver. It's down 28 cents. You're at 1440. Yeah, but it's just, they haven't broken it yet. Bottom line is that what this is doing, it's going against the swing point from the 24th of July. That high of that is 1471. The low is 1433. We did 54,000 contracts there. Thus far, we've still only done 36,000 contracts. So the metals market in particular, folks, okay, has been a market, no doubt, that has gone one way, and that one way is south. What has also continued to happen, though, is that it keeps rejecting lower price. If we go take a look at the copper market, copper right now is trading at $234.50, and it looks to me like that the copper market is going to be the first one to come off this bottom. That's the way it seems to be setting up right now. Copper got down to a price point of 232 today. We're at 235.50. Last swing low out here was 233.75. It has to get inside the 238.70. And the reason that I'm suspecting that copper is the first one, if you take a look at one of the largest copper stocks in the world, which is SCCO, which we happen to own too, is this. Is that when you take a look at this, what it's done is this. You put this on a weekly basis first, is that it didn't break in all these lower swing points, which in fact just about every metal stock did. You know, the consolidation this has been in, you know, long time consolidation, but guess what? They couldn't break down. So we'll see how this shakes out, you know, but thus far it's shaken out that it looks to me like that wants to go higher. That we'll find out real soon if, in fact, copper in the base metals are going to be the first ones off the bottom. If we go take a look at the iron ore market, there's no buyers there yet either. If you could look at Valley, you're just going sideways. What Valley did get, though, last Thursday is that it got into the price point of 592. And it has some juice up there, so that's saying it does want to get back up. If we go over and we take a look at Randgold Resources inside the gold market, I like what that's doing out here today. Still need buyers, but bottom line is that you back down $2. You're backing into a price point of 58.28. You're doing that with 460,000 shares versus the last time we were down here with 1.2 million. So that's a decent signs saying we have no sellers. Now, the question is, do we have any buyers? See, because if you go over to an Eco Eagle, bottom line, it's going, it's breaking lows with lighter volume, but that's saying, guess what? Can't hold price. And when it can't hold price, that's a problem, period, inside markets that are going into lower price. Let's go take a look at the FCX. Now, FCX, folks, is the largest copper mine and one of the largest oil players. But they bought oil right at the wrong time. So we're at 11.16. This is something that you want to keep your eye on. The reason being is that you have a couple different bottoms out here that it's trying to get into. I suspect we're going to probably get into this $7 or $8 level, which is just pretty wild. But what it's also saying is that the energy market is going to go a lot lower. If we go take a look at unleaded gas today, unleaded gas is down 9 cents, folks. 9 cents with 46,000 contracts. That's an ABC down. That's saying unleaded wants to go to, let's see, 196, 72, 82, 92, 24 cents. So we're going to $1.50. We're going, all right. Yeah, we're going to $1.55 in unleaded. That is some inexpensive gas. Now, that's wholesale, folks, but that will continue to bring the prices down at the pump. Yeah, I know. It's pretty amazing. Inside that commodity market out here, this is what you have. You have gasoline's down 5%, crude oil's down 3.7. Heating oil, for all you folks, next year up at up northeast, you might want to fill it up. It's down 3.3 right now. The commodities that are up, you get orange juice up 3.6. That's live hogs are up 2.5. You get cattle up 1.5. That's about it in the context of how the commodity markets are affecting things. Some of the high volume stocks in this market, we take a look at the S&P. This is what you have. Bank of America is down 15. Apple continues to basically get lower price into the close. That's down at 337. I expect you're going to see more selling. We'll see. There may be funds that pull the plug on Apple as we do get into this close today. Most times, that doesn't show up for the next day after you break a 200. We'll see if that's going to change out here today. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per a $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. And so Microsoft, you know, we get a lot of companies that have a lot of cash overseas, but check this out. So Microsoft stockpile of offshore profits rose to $108 billion, which is a 17% increase over the past year, according to the company filings with the SEC. The company crossed the $100 billion mark, making it just the second U.S. corporation after General Electric to do so, according to filings as of Friday, July 31st. Apple has more cash abroad than Microsoft, but it already had assumed for accounting purposes that it will pay a tax on some of its stockpile and thus have less than $70 billion offshore that would affect earnings directly if they were brought back here. While keeping with Microsoft's cash abroad is what's keeping Microsoft's cash abroad is the U.S. tax code. The company would be required to pay the difference between its foreign taxes and a 35% corporate tax rate. If to get to the $108 billion back, Microsoft would have to pay $34.4 billion. Well, big deal. You talk about toasting and roasting, folks, okay? When they throw someone under the bus, the financial business, they throw them under the bus in a big way. So when we take a look at, we go overseas, and the so-called ringmaster of rate rigging got 14 years today. Former UBS Group and Citigroup trader Tom Hayes, the first person to stand trial for manipulating LIBOR, was sentenced to 14 years in prison after being found guilty of conspiracy to rig the benchmark rise. After a week of deliberations, jurors unanimously found that the 35-year-old worked with traders and brokers to game the London interbank offered rate to benefit his own trading positions. The LIBOR activities on which you took part, this is the judge talking, you took part and put jeopardy in the whole banking system. Hayes, dressed in prosecutor, said during the nine-week trial that Hayes was the ringmaster of a global network of 25 traders and brokers from at least 10 firms who tried to manipulate LIBOR on an industrial scale. He would bribe, bully, cajole, and reward his contacts for their help in skewing the benchmark used to price more than $350 trillion of financial contracts from mortgages to credit cards and student loans. The scruffy, blonde-haired Hayes, who had been the public face of the global scandal over LIBOR rigging since it was first charged in the U.S. in 2012, authorities have leveled $9 billion in fines against banks and brokerages, including $1.5 billion for UBS. Citigroup has been censured by the Japanese regulator over its involvement, meaning they can't trade bonds over there. Before sentences, Hayes lawyers reiterated their defense that the benchmark manipulation was widespread in the industry. Bottom line is that this is the typical situation, folks, of you know, traders getting thrown under the bus and their bosses, meaning the banks, going free after they turn around and pay the aspect. Well, the banks so far, what did I just say? Yeah, the bank so far came up with $9.9 billion so that none of the executives go to jail. Bottom line, though, you can see how this whole thing works out. So Amazing. It just doesn't stop. And, you know, what is amazing is that if we go over, let's just go over and take a look at Bank of America for a second, BAC, because what you do have is that no matter how many fines these banks have had, it seems that inside some of their filings lately, they're actually saying that they still are going to have more numbers coming in the future. BAC is trading 1776. You get back inside 1772, and you know that sets up Bank of America wants to go to lower price, and it's like, man, you know, the amazing part is that until this financial debacle in 2007, you know, I absolutely knew that banking is a good structure, making money hand over fist, because you're making money without money. You know, that the fiat system. And what happens specifically in that fiat system, folks, is this. Is that they only need a base of 10% to loan out 100%. So they can take a dollar, loan $10, get interest on the $10. You can see how much paying interest on $1, getting interest on $10. So you can see how they can make money out of air. And that's the structure. That being said, it just seems phenomenal that they can pay that many fines and still make money. Okay, so there's more to that than just the leverage between a dollar and $10 and you know, bottom line, getting an honest spread on supposedly how the banking system works. And of course, what we find out, you know, as you continue going forward, each and every market that they seem to be in, they're manipulating, they're, you know, they claim that they're trading it. They're not trading the market, folks. They're trading against their own clients. That's what they're doing. The very large banks, really easy way to do this. The way the technology's set up right now, you have the bids and offers. Those bids and offers, okay, for large companies, for the large banks, they don't go into the market first. What they do, as their CFAs are putting orders in, those go to those trading desks right now. They pick those trading, they pick that off on a continual basis. Then it can go out to the marketplace. That's how the bulk of money is made, that they can pay these fines on a continual basis. When they get caught, it's pocket change. You can see, their management certainly are not going anywhere. 877-927-6648. We go take a look coming. Let's see, what are we at? You're at 48. You're coming into, let me just look. Yeah, they're gonna Apple's going after that low again. And it looks like what Apple's gonna do, and this is gonna put pressure, because Apple has been in a consolidation for such a period of time. And when we take a look at it, the consolidation that we're talking about is pretty amazing, actually. Well, it's just like the market. It's going back to February. What we have happening is that you're breaking a swing point. Now, you're breaking the swing on lighter volume. The swing that we're breaking was the last low that was established on July 9th. That low there had volume of 78 million. Actually, you know, we could do that, though. If someone freaks out on Apple going into the close, you can actually get that, because right now we're at 64 million, and they'll put orders in at the close. And what we have had thus far on Apple coming in, your largest number, which could be at the close too, your largest number thus far, largest trade, was at the open. You had actually someone come in with 508,000. So that level there, they were actually probably, it's hard to tell whether they were buying or selling. But that being said, meaning a trade of 508,000, you could have a trade coming into that close of a million. You get a trade of a million coming into the close on Apple, that would set up a break of that lower price point with some real juice behind the move. We go take a look at the Amazon, AMZN. Amazon thus far has held up pretty good. We're down $1.83. It hasn't filled that gap yet, you know, at 534. That gap's going to get filled, though, below it. And that's a nasty gap. That gap is, the bottom of that gap is at 491. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We come right back. Dow's down 110. Nasdaq's off 19. S&P's are off 10. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's see what we have happening out here inside some of these Dow stocks. You have Caterpillar's down $1.47, ExxonMobil's down $1.22, Oxy's down $0.88, you have Walmart up $0.17. Big Blue is down 347. That she's trading out at 158.51. You get Merck flat. 3M is down 131. And it's the oil and gas. You get Chevron is the culprit, but inside the Dow, that culprit is Apple and IBM. You know, Apple is down to 323, and that's a large weighting structure, and so isn't Big Blue. Inside the NDX 100, as we come into the close out here, the pressure, the selling pressure is one of Apple's suppliers, I believe that's SWKS. That's down 311. Outside of that, it's not the end of the world. Now, what hasn't broke down is the IBB. If we go take a look at the IBB, what you're going to see, this is the biotech index. This is still trading 381.79. What we will have is that tomorrow, I believe, it's before the market open. Okay, so before the market opens tomorrow, Regeneron, R-E-G-N, is going to be coming out with numbers. Now, this is a high flyer extraordinaire. It's trading at 554, and this run has been just about as big a run as that you'll see any stock do. This, if you go back to 2011, the stock's at $35. Straight one-way shot, right up to 569. Now, the last time it had any juice was up at the price point of 495. So that's not bad. You know, that also says, however, that you could open at 495 in a heartbeat, which is only $60. $60 for one of these biotechs, folks, down is not a big deal. You know, it goes up $60 like nothing. The largest surprise in the last few weeks was Biogen, when Biogen went down 20% in one trading day. That, no doubt, for an individual stock was a big number. For the biotechs themselves, for the IBB, guess what? It really didn't destroy the IBB. Now, my take is that the IBB does want to go lower. Why? Because each and every one of these swing points has volume on the way down, just as our own markets have volume on the way down. The IBB, however, is still outside the lower trading range. You know, so it's not proof in the pudding yet until that little baby gets inside the lower trading range. You know, what we do have out here today, though, is the larger caps, including IBM, looks like it's going to blow. Actually, IBM is an ABC down. It just did it. So watch this. When we started the program, we were wondering whether IBM could get the juice inside it. Well, it got it pretty quick. IBM right now is at 158.50. Oh, look at this. Oh, my God. This is the trip. Okay, so you know what the swing point is? The swing point, folks, is 158.50. And we're at 158.49. The volume is 3.7 million. So we've already taken the volume out. Now the key is going to be, can you close below the price? And if that's what you get, your A point on this is 173. Your B is 158. So you're dealing with what? That's 12. That's 15 bucks. Your C point is the high that was established on Friday, and then you're going to end up with a 147, you know, and we haven't been down to 147. Let's see what 147 is in Big Blue. Well, this is where this gets interesting. So check this out. 147, I bring this back. That would be breaking out the consolidation that this has been in, going all the way back to October of 2014. This is a big problem for IBM. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming back with some numbers after the close. Dow down 110. NASDAQ off 19. S&P's off for 9.5. We're going to bring it back.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Nick in Tampa. Hey, Nick, what's going on?
Tom O'Brien, it is an absolute pleasure.
Thanks so much, man. We appreciate you calling.
No problem. Dude, I've been listening to your show for about 2 years now, and it has just been wonderful. I listen to you, Basil, Andy. You guys do an amazing job.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling out here with us.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. This quote is by Natalie Goldberg. Follow what you love, and it will take you where you want to go. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow down 91, NASDAQ down 12, S&P's off 7.5, gold contract down $9.30, trading at 1,085 an ounce. Silver down 26 cents at $14.48 an ounce. Platinum down 20 at $9.62 an ounce. Copper flat at $2.40 a pound. Light sweet crude down $1.71 at $45.41 a barrel. Bonds, folks, oil broke a B point, broke it with volume. Probability goes a lot higher that we get a structure down to 41. We'll see how we trade out at that 41 area. I have two separate ABC downs. One of them is at 35. The low is 42. Bottom line, this thing came down with velocity out here today. Now, bonds, they go up with wide price spread, with accelerated volume. Bonds want higher price. You had the 10-year up 12 ticks, 127.25. 30-year up a point and 22 ticks at 157.20. In both cases, you had real juice behind those moves higher. They want a lot higher price. They've broken out of their ranges that they have been trading in since going back to this past May. So what that's saying is that bonds are going to go test the highs that were generated out here. And, you know, we'll see whether we bust those highs. When you take a look at the bond market, folks, when we go from highs to lows, that correlation thus far, what you have had is that we did a 50% retracement of the move. And when I'm talking about 50% retracement of the move, bonds had hit. Let me pull this up here so you can see how this baby shakes out. What had happened is that, you know, bonds were on a one-way trip going topside in 2015, April of 2015, you know, we hit the highs out here in bonds. They pull all the way back to where they originally broke topside from, rejected that level. Now that's saying they want to go back to the highs that were generated in April of 2014. You know, in 2015, rather. And we'll see whether, in fact, that wants to get taken out. The yield on them, the 10-year right now is yielding 2.1. So bottom line is that yield, it wants to go under 2 once again. King dollar. What do we have with King dollar? King dollar is just the opposite, folks. You hear that, you know, the strength in King dollar. But the bottom line, King dollar hasn't. The last swing high in King dollar was in March of this year. That high was 101.10. Each and every time King dollar just even tries to get up to the 98 area, can't handle it. It loses it on price, loses it on volume. Friday, we actually got that lower at 96.37 with volume on the way down. So what you have in that situation, dollar still wants lower price out here. 93.30. What's intriguing about that, of course, is that the commodity markets have continued to basically get sold off. Inside the commodity markets out here today, the biggest sell-off was in unleaded gas. So all you folks driving right now, and of course all of us that drive, period, we're going to be saving quite a bit of money. The gasoline was down 5% today. Unleaded gas was down 5%. It was down almost 9 pennies. Now, this baby also broke a B point, and it just ripped it apart of an ABC structure on the way down. This is saying gasoline wants to get out of 155. What's intriguing about this is that the last low in gas last March was 163. So the way this is trading right now is that it actually is saying that it wants to go to lower prices than the last swing low that we had out there. The oil market itself, big numbers, folks, okay? We did 346,000 contracts out here today in oil. You broke an additional B point. That B point had 338,000 contracts. We did 346. It took it apart, with volume. That is setting up a 41 barrel in oil. That, by the way, is only an A to B equals C to D. Now, let's go take a look at the S&Ps. What do we have inside the S&Ps? This is what you have. SPY came down today, 109 million shares. Slight expansion of volume. You closed out at 209.73. Bottom line, we'll see what type of follow-through we get tomorrow. The way this is set up, couldn't handle higher price. What's unusual for a Monday in the marketplace is to come down so quick, particularly inside window dressing. Now, what we did not have is that you did not have that expansion with real heavy volume. We did We did 832 million. That's not a lot in the way back. You know, that's inside the NYSE. We take a look at the NASDAQ. The NASDAQ come back with 1.7. So that pullback was light volume today. Now, the Qs came back with 24 million. For the Qs, 24 million, that's volume. We try to get the highs on Friday with 22 million. And inside the Qs, I suspect where the market is going to have a problem tomorrow morning is going to be Apple. You know, Apple broke its 200-day moving average. It hasn't broken that average in almost 2 years, folks. That's a number one. But what it also did is that we did it with 69 million shares. I believe it was going up to 74 million, maybe 84 million, 78 million. So you broke it with lighter volume, but you're a point, 80 cents below it. So Apple's going to go a lot lower, you know. And what you are going to have tomorrow morning, I suspect even pre-market, is that you're going to have plenty of black boxes that show up tonight that Apple, in fact, is underneath that 200-day moving average. And when, of course, there's plenty of big funds that you get underneath that 200-day moving average, they just want to basically move it out. That particularly, you know, after the amount of time that we have gone sideways. What we did have in the close, on the open today, you had 508,000. That was the trade. On the close, it was 1.488 million. You know, so there was some pressure coming into that close out here today. Gold, what do we have at the gold market? We take a look at gold. This is what you have happening with gold. Now, at 130, gold was only down $5. You still only did 102,000 contracts out here. They haven't been able to get it to lower price. The 102,000 contracts is coming into 174,000. You know, way it's set up, though, it's like, okay, we're at 1085. That baby's going to go right after 1073 once again, you know. The metals market, folks, has less sellers, but we still don't have any buyers. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. Dow finished down 91. NASDAQ off 12.5. S&P's off 7.5. Stay right there, folks. Coming right back with our man, Mr. Kevin Hinks from TD Ameritrade. Think or swim. Be right back.
Tom O'Brien has just announced a live online workshop taking place Wednesday, August 12th, six trades for September. This special event will be open to all subscribers to his daily newsletter, Market Insights. Tom will walk you through six trade setups in the market he's identified setting up for September. Two long positions, two short positions, and two option trades. New subscribers will also receive a free copy of his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, an $88 value. But we're not done yet. We're also including a Tiger's Den membership as part of all Market Insights subscriptions at no cost as well. You get Tom O'Brien's best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, 30 days of his newsletter, Market Insights, access to his live online workshop, Six Trades for September, and access to the Tiger's Den. This offer is only valid for 2 weeks, so don't miss out. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to Market Insights at the front page of TFNN.com today. Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A shares hot or not? If you trade China A shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-Share bull and bear ETFs. China A-Shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom,
Take your phone calls
now.
Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Why not? What's going on in your world? Now, you know, we had Greece. Bottom line is we get something closer than Greece. We get Puerto Rico. So Puerto Rico is in default right now. And this was the first time, I believe, that it's not that the government of Puerto Rico actually has backed these bonds, too. But it is from one of the agencies, one of the government agencies. So a Puerto Rican agency defaulted on bonds for the first time Monday, initiating a clash with creditors as the struggling Commonwealth, so check this out, seeks to renegotiate $72 billion. They get $72 billion in debt. It has here that the Caribbean island paid $628,000 out of, I think it was a $58 million payment. Big deal, right? Yeah, the default marks an escalation of the debt crisis racking the island, where officials are pushing for what may be the biggest restructuring ever in the municipal market. Puerto Rican bond prices have tumbled amid speculation that the island won't be able to repay what it owes. It has, now check this out, folks. We're talking about $58 billion that was due Saturday, it didn't get paid. But they have, in the next 12 months, they have $58 million. They have $5 billion that's coming due in the next 12 months. The real key is gonna be inside of this. Number one, are they gonna get paid? Number two, which is the bigger ramification though, who is holding the bag on this and, you know, will they get paid? You know, it's intriguing too, because when you go over, and if we go over to the DAX just for a second, because I wanna show you something. When you look at the DAX, now the DAX was up today. You're trading right now at a price point of 11,443, and you know, inside the DAX, of course, is that the whole Greece deal realistically was about German banks. You know, that's German banks are the ones that were on the hook. They all were playing dear devil between the political countries, meaning you know, Greece, Germany, the banks in general, but bottom line is that what do you have once again? Well, once again, you have that bailout, and that bailout, I suspect, was for the Greek banks. I mean, for the German banks, it wasn't so much for the citizens, and you know, we'll see where it shakes out. So this is going to be intriguing to see how this shakes out in Puerto Rico, because what you do have, you have a huge amount of, I suspect, mutual funds that are going to own their debt. That's the way this has come down. That's where I think this thing's going to probably more than likely affect, whether it's pensions, whether it's unions, you know, all of the above. Some of the high volume stocks we had out here today in this low volume market, because it was a low volume market out here today, is this. You had Apple down 283. We had Cisco down 6. Tyson Foods got hit. That was down $4. You had ExxonMobil off $1.15. Some of the Dow stocks, we had Big Blue down 328. If we pull up Big Blue for a second, we take a look at Big Blue. This is serious business for Big Blue, and this is what it is. Big Blue has been in a consolidation, I believe it's almost 3 years right now. Maybe not that long. Okay, so it's October 2014. Oh, no, it's only a year. Man, okay, so it's a year. Big Blue had come off its high of 192, gapped down with monster volume into this 160 area. What is happening right now is that Big Blue, on a daily basis, took out a B point on ABC structure on the way down. That is saying that it's going to go break the bottom of its consolidation. Now, you break the bottom of this consolidation, which I do expect you're going to see in Big Blue, then you're going to see some big trouble, because this consolidation right now, Big Blue is trading where it was trading in 2011, but it looks like Big Blue wants to trade down to a price point of 116. You go to 116 and you're coming off 158. That will put an enormous amount of pressure inside the Dow Industrials. And of course, the wild card out here is going to be what is Apple going to be doing tomorrow morning? And when I say tomorrow morning, the reason I say tomorrow morning, because Apple, this has been a very fast run down on Apple, you know, meaning the last 2 weeks. Apple is trading at 132, you know, it gave up, there's a 118 right now, broke a swing point, broke with volume. But the larger issue is that it's actually broke the consolidation that has been trading in since February of 2015. And that's how the market's trading, folks. The market, you know, if we go take a look at the SPX, we're at the same place that we were. You know, you can make an argument that it was a sideways movement out here today in the SPX because it's only down $5, $5.50. We're at the same place that we were trading out in February of 2015. 2097. That's exactly where we were February 12th. Actually, February 13th. Same place. The difference, however, is this. When you take a look at it, if you want to see the correlations inside highs and inside lows, each and every time that this baby is trying to bust the 2119 area, has no volume. Each and every time it busts down to the 2039 level, you had juice. You take that in with the consideration that the amount of equities that have actually busted through those bottoms have volume as they busted through those bottoms. Then you take into consideration whether it's the IBMs of the world, the Apples of the world. Those are the equities that got us into higher price. No, IBM is certainly not. Apple is, though. You will see how this baby shakes out. What we will have, and this is going to be a big number tomorrow morning for the NASDAQ, that is Regeneron. Regeneron is going to be come out with the numbers before the open tomorrow. That's at 5:54, and this was a rocket ship one-way rocket ship. There's no two ways about that. That rocket ship basically went last 5 years from $34 up into the stratosphere. But, you know, bottom line, the way Regeneron looks right now, it could pull back maybe $50. You know, we'll see where that shakes out. When Amgen came out with those numbers, Amgen got up to the price point of 181. It's holding that level though. We're at 175. You know, Amgen had sold off that day. You pull back today, you have lighter volume. Biogen is the one that really got hit. Biogen was down 20%. Celgene, CELG, that baby had already come out. That's still hanging at highs. Celgene has a large gap that it does want to close, but it's hanging at highs. And Gilead is also hanging at highs. So most of those biotechs still are saying that they want higher price. And inside the NASDAQ composite itself, that is what's holding it up. Now, but the composite, however, has released the amount of information that each and every time the composite is coming down, it does have juice on the way down. In fact, the composite has more volume on the way down. When you look at the percentage differential on the way down versus the way up, than the S&P does. There's more clarity inside the composite. The composite right now is at 5115, and bottom line is that anything under 5119 is saying you're in the lower range. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We will be having Kevin back this time from TD Ameritrade Thinkorswim. And if you've never heard a show, folks, Kevin has the best show on the planet, best option show on the planet. It's every Tuesday, 12 to 1 Eastern Standard Time. If you're in your car, it's really easy to remember on your cell phone. TFNN.MOBI. You can get that anywhere in the world. Noon tomorrow. We'll come right back with Kevin. Stay right there.
If you're looking for a great opportunity to diversify your financial portfolio, consider the Principal Protected Market Safe CD from EverBank. They've just released the second running of their 5-year Market Safe Power Metal CD, which combines the power of gold, silver, and copper. You get exposure to 3 valuable metals in 1 index CD and have the potential to earn up to 45% capped upside payment at maturity if the metals increase in value across annual pricing dates. And should they decrease, no worries. There's zero risk to your deposited principal here, as you still get 100% of it back. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There is no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on the CD. Intrigued yet? The August 17th funding deadline is quickly approaching. So hurry over to everbank.com/TFNN-CD for more information, including important product details and disclosures. Once again, that's everbank.com/TFNN-CD. EverBank is a member FDIC.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
TFNN has just announced a brand new morning lineup that is geared specifically for traders in this volatile traders market. Every morning at 8 a.m., John Logan starts things off with his daily program, The Global Market Pulse. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento trades the market during the market open Monday through Friday on Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom O'Brien hosts the Money Masters for the hour, and Basil Chapman hosts his Tiger Technician's Hour at 11 a.m. From 8 a.m. till noon every market day, these traders are with you as they provide up-to-the-second market information so that you can make the most educated and profitable trades possible. The new TFNN morning lineup is happening right now. Tune in to see for yourself what kind of actionable trading discussion they have each morning, Monday through Friday, starting at 8 a.m., live only on Tiger TV at TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We had the Dow finished down 91. NASDAQ was off 12. S&Ps were off 7.5. And as we do each and every Monday, at the bottom of the second hour, we get our man, Mr. Kevin Hinks from TD Ameritrade, Think or Swim. Now, Kevin has the best option show on the planet, folks. It's right here every Tuesday, 12 to 1 Eastern Standard Time. You can get it right on your cell phone at tfnn.mobi. That'll get you the audio. You want to get the Tiger TV with the video and the audio, just go to tfnn.com on your cell browser. Hit the right-hand side. You'll see the box with devices in it. Our servers know exactly what you're on. You'll get Tiger TV delivered. You'll see the great charts. You'll see the different strategies that TD Ameritrade, Think or Swim, that Kevin lines up for you. And if you haven't test drove the platform, folks, come over to our website, hit the banner, and test drive the platform. The platform is a phenomenal platform. You can test drive it. You can trade paper money with it. I use it each and every trading day, whether I'm trading options, commodities, futures, or currencies. It's on one platform. But the analytics on this, too, is absolutely phenomenal. Now, if you want to take a nice trip, guess what? October 14th to 16th, Las Vegas. The Paris Hotel in Las Vegas. Guess what? You can go out there. The Traders Expo's out there. We're going to be out there. Kevin's going to be out there. Think or Swim's going to be out there. Some great classes are out there, and they're all free, folks. Kevin Hinks, what's going on?
Tom O'Brien, how you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great, man. Hey, listen, another day up, down, and all around, and we're still back where we were in February of 2014.
Strange day, wasn't it?
Yeah,
I came in, I couldn't believe that futures weren't weaker.
Yeah.
Based on the Greek stock market and Puerto Rico, I thought we'd be lower. And then the minute it opened, kind of muted, then they hit it.
And what Kevin's talking about, folks, okay, so check this out. Mondays and Fridays in the summer anyway, okay, are basically, normally dull markets, okay?
Sleepy.
They are. And the first leg down in the S&P today was like, oh, really? It's like, okay, someone just wanted to take this thing south. And they took it south pretty quick, folks. And what that shows is that there's no bids there. That was unusual, Kevin. I turned around and said, I'm shot biased right now, but I was even saying, wow, that was interesting for a Monday morning. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. And then did you see the end of the day when the rumor came out that Puerto Rico was making a payment? The VIX all but crashed.
This is
in about a 2-minute period.
Okay, this is really cool. So watch this, folks. I saw this in our trading room, and I didn't I didn't know what the rumor was, okay? And,
yeah.
And what had happened, folks, is this, is that the S&P itself threw in a bunch of handles. The VIX, you know, went from 1339 to 1256 in about a heartbeat. Now, the ironic part of all of that is that they made a payment, but out of the $58 million, they made a payment of $600,000, right?
$628,000. Talking about teardrops and tidal waves.
You know what's so cool about that, right? Which, folks, this is what's so sick. What's so cool is that it gets you to really understand, though, how markets move and how, you know, all of us as traders, but the much larger players, you know, want to move markets, right? I mean, that's the reality. And when I see that, Kevin, that gives me more conviction, really, that, okay, you know, this thing wants to go south. It's still rolling, you know, because when you have something like that and you get the handles going and then it's 600,000, it's okay, show me the money.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. That was not one for buying.
No, no. You know what's going to be intriguing here, too, is that this is the first time Apple broke its 200-day moving average in almost 2 years.
Yes, big news there. And the last time they were talking about it went down considerably further.
Yeah, yeah.
So don't know if it's going to happen this time because it's had a good sell-off here.
Yeah, no, it has. It was fast.
It's going to move with the market now. Because it's in the Dow, it's going to move with futures now.
Yeah, which is pretty incredible, no doubt. So talk to me about what we're going to talk about tomorrow. And by the way, your show is outstanding, man. I mean,
thank you very much.
I learned
so
much.
We're having a lot of fun. Tomorrow we're going to talk about some high-end content. We're going to show your viewers how to beta weight their position and hedge it from a total portfolio perspective.
Oh, that's so cool, man. Right.
Yeah, we're going to do some high-end stuff. So we're going to teach them how to take an entire portfolio, however big it is,
yep,
compare it to an index, and then hedge it.
Okay, so now check this out, folks. So picture, because, you know, when you've been in the market a long period of time and I get a lot of different things happening, I've had a Bloomberg forever, okay? I've had a Bloomberg, it's 21 years now, okay? And I use... Kevin knows, once you get hooked on these, you get hooked on them. But I don't even need a Bloomberg.
You get a comfort zone. You're in a comfort zone, right?
Right. But my point is, I don't even need it anymore. So check this out, folks. Bloomberg used to be the only one that can do what Kevin is talking about right now, okay? Bottom line, Thinkorswim has been doing this for a long period of time. But I remember when it first came out, I says, oh, look at this, man. You know, and you know how it goes, Kevin. I'm just like, it's like, oh, man. And sometimes it's because... I'm certainly not trading off. I'm trading off the Thinkorswim platform. But whether it's news or something else, or it's exactly what you're talking about, but it's intriguing how far, you know, and how intense the Thinkorswim TD Ameritrade platform is, man.
Yeah, it's crazy. And we just had John Hart on our little show today talking about how the mobile platform has really come along.
Yeah.
The fastest growing part of this is our mobile platform, and people are trading off their phone.
Well, I've done it. And what happens, and just so you understand how this works, folks, is that the platforms, okay, set specifically for the device you're on, okay? Which is so cool. So it's not like you're basically jumping on your phone and going through a browser trying to figure out, okay, what a website looks like. It's specific to the phone, which is, yeah, it really is dynamite. So
some high-end stuff.
It is some high-end stuff, man, no doubt. Okay, so we're going to be looking and the hedging aspect, by the way, too, folks, okay? When Kevin walks you through it, you can actually see how you can go delta neutral. And what that means specifically is this, is that you can take a portfolio and say, okay, listen, whether the market goes up or down, I'm going to be flat and move out of this market for a certain period of time.
Now, and you can actually time the market, right? You can say, you know, once it gets here, I'm getting flat without selling your stocks out.
Exactly. And you know what I think is so cool about that, Kevin, is that what I say to people is that, okay, listen, if you're happy where you are right now, okay, you very well, hey, listen, man, you can give up 5%, 10%, all of that if it goes up. That can happen. But
sure.
Guess what? The other side of that, meaning if you go down 5 or 10%, well, you just got to figure out what you're happy with, okay? Because you are getting insulated to that. And if I've learned anything over the course of years, it just means It's not how much money you make. It's how much money you lose before you're making the money at the end of the day. What is the bottom line?
Right. We're going to teach you direction and duration.
Nice. Have to love it. I like it.
Well, am I going to see you in Las Vegas in October?
You sure are.
We'll look forward to
that. And you're going to see all these tigers and tigresses because you've been doing the show long enough. They're going to be showing up there growling and prowling with you and your crew.
Two Irish guys, look out.
That's right, man. Okay, brother. Well, listen, you have a great one, a safe one. And, of course, we look forward to the show tomorrow.
Can't wait to see you tomorrow. Have a good day,
Thanks,
Tom.
Man. Okay, bye-bye. That show, folks, 12 to 1 Eastern Standard Time. Get right on your cell phone, tfnn.mobi. Dow finished down 91. You had the NASDAQ off, 12 and a half. S&P's down 8.5. You stay right there, folks. Be coming right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting tfnn.com. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. And, we were talking about banks and the German banks in particular with the getting paid when Greece got bailed out. Well, Deutsche Bank just can't seem to basically get out from underneath. So federal prosecutors today, they're investigating billions of dollars worth of trades that Deutsche Bank did on behalf of Russian clients this year. The Justice Department criminal probe, which hasn't been previously reported, focuses on so-called merit trades. Such trades may have allowed Russian clients to move funds out of the country without properly alerting authorities. The new inquiry adds a wave to legal challenges to Germany's largest bank, which you take the market, folks. They've been in the middle of it. Now, the way this works, and this happens a lot, folks, by the way, the way this works, so picture this, this is how this shakes out. The Ameritrade, and that's Mirror, M-I-R-R-O-R, not a M-I, takes trades that their clients would be in Russia. And, you know, the sanctions came in Russia. Bottom line, you could have money in Russia. You have a problem situation, right? Well, bottom line is that what you can do, you can hedge that and offset that across the world with trades that will mimic you selling that in Russia. That's what this deal is all about. And of course, because of sanctions, what's supposed to happen? You know, bottom line is there was supposed to be no dealings done in that aspect. You know, at Deutsche Bank, I believe that they already paid us. Yeah, they paid $2.5 billion for basically fixing the London interbank rates. And, you know, inside that whole structure, the $2.5 billion. So they paid $2.5 billion, make sure none of their executives go away. Well, the first one got sentenced today, 14 years in jail, 34-year-old kid. But the Russian deal is going to, that's going to open up a whole can of worms, because what you did have is that they have already got grabbed, I believe. Yeah, because Bloomberg reported this before. Bloomberg reported June 5th that there was $6 billion in trades that were connected with money laundering by Russian clients, okay? You know, so we'll see where that shakes out. What seems to be happening here is that the banks themselves, it just seems like there's zero rules. You know, we might have Dodd-Frank and all the rest of the above, but it seems like it's time after time after time. And there is absolutely, I mean, how many more scandals can there be? You know, I guess there can be quite a few of them. We go back over what you did have. Apple did close under that 200-day moving average. That, no doubt, tonight will put a lot of pressure on a lot of different funds. We did the 69 million shares going into 72 million. It's a decent breakdown. Now, let's go over to the oil and gas complex. So if we take a look at the XLE, this has been a one-way route also. And something to remember is that inside a one-way route, bottom line, you know, these things can go a lot lower. What we did out here today is that the XLE broke the swing point of 68.21. Now, we broke it with 400,000 light of volume, but this looks like an additional ABC structure on the way down. The XLE has been a one-way route, 83 to 67. You take a look at this, and we put this on a monthly basis. What you're going to see is that we're trading into already the highs of the October 2011 bar. Now, the high of that bar, folks, is 73. We're already 5 points into it. That's saying we're going to go to 54. That's insane. But guess what? That's where we're going. You know, 54, that's going to bring these large integrated ExxonMobils of the world dramatically lower. Exxon's paying a 3.75% dividend at this price. Don't touch it. Chevron was down out here today, 288. That's paying a 5% dividend. Don't touch it. Okay, Chevron CVX. Chevron broke the B point with volume. Chevron's got some real juice behind it. That broke the $88.74 price point today. We had 10 million shares. They unloaded 14 million shares. You know, so Chevron's already gone from the 112 to 85. This structure here very well can take it. You get 101, get 12 bucks. You're talking... Well, 80 bucks, not the end of the world. 80 bucks, we're at 85 already. But $80, let's see what $80 takes this to. Well, your next stop is 83. So what 83 is on Chevron, 83 is going to be the high of the low. And we'll see how that handles that 83 area. So 83 was the high of the low of 2008. The low was 55.50. You know, if the oil industry is going to be anything like the metal industry, meaning are these equities actually going to get into those lows, it's like, is it because we have so much oil out there, or in fact, are things slowing up? I suspect inside the oil industry, it looks to me like we have a slew of oil. The reason being is that when you take a look at the gasoline went down 5% out here. And what we do know is that when you look at the amount of cars that are sold, people are buying the Explorers again, they're buying the SUVs, people are using gas. But the gas contract out here today, that baby went south, had the volume. It's been a one-way deal going from 204, right now you're 168. This ABC structure on the way down is gonna give us a 155, you know? And we'll see, you know, if we actually get to 155, I can make the case that you're gonna get 40 cents. My God, that'd be crazy. Let me just see this for a second. I think I can make the case that we can get to 120. Let me put this, I'm gonna put this on a continuous contract so you can see what I'm looking at here. So if we put this up, well, that would make sense, I guess. Yeah, it would make sense. The low is 122. So, and where that comes from, folks, is that when we broke this 169.25 on a continuous contract, it's like there's nothing else holding it up. And, you know, if we turn around and we look at it in the context of a retracement and how we did a retracement, you know, when we came down, it was a straight line down from $3.15. That was the high in 2014, down to 122. You did a counter trend bounce. It was exact 50% retracement to 218. Now you're at 168. So when you do a 50% retracement on the way up or the way down, what it indicates is this, is that number one, once you start moving downtown, which we are, it's gonna go test it. Number two, we'll see, it can take it out and you could have an ABC structure on the way down. Now, if that was the case of an ABC on the way down, that would really, let's see where this lines up. That would be insane. That'd be almost a $2 ABC. I don't see that happening. I don't see that happening. Because that would give us 18-cent gas. We're not going to have 18-cent gas. Bottom line, though, we are going to have lower gas prices. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow down 51, down 91 rather. NASDAQ down 12, S&P's off 7.5. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great
long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering four-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per a $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These four-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at tfnn.com.
Welcome back, folks. We had the Dow finished down 91. Nasdaq was off 12. S&Ps are off 7.5. And as you come over to our website at TFNN, folks, you're going to see right in the top of the carousel, we got a great special that's going on, and this is what it's all about. I'm going to be doing a webinar. It's a free webinar for my subscribers of Market Insights. That webinar is going to be on the 12th of August, 5:30 to 6:30 Eastern Standard Time. What we're going to be talking about in that webinar, we're going to be setting up is this. We're going to be setting up a couple long trades, a couple short trades, and a couple option trades in the marketplace of where I think a few of these are going. We certainly have the volatility that's inside this marketplace now, which is a great deal for traders. If you'd like to subscribe to my daily newsletter, you can do it for free right now. That's $169 value. You will also get a copy of my book, The Art of Time in the Trade. You'll get into the Tiger's Den for 1 month, and you get that workshop. So check it out on the front page of TFNN. That is available for the next nine trading days. Next 9 days. Because we're at the fourth tomorrow, and it's going to be the 12th. So check it out right in the front page of TFNN. What I do expect you're going to see out here is that more than likely you're going to see a bit of follow-through inside this marketplace. And most of that follow-through, we'll actually be able to tell, more than likely a little bit, whether it's hour, 2 hours tonight inside the future market. Because this is what you have. The NQs just couldn't handle the higher price. As Kevin and I we're talking about the fast sell-off this morning, that basically came out of nowhere. Bottom line, sold down quite a few handles. Now, what the market no doubt did do is that you get that counter trend bounce all the way back, and that was fast and furious. Also, the key that you want to wrap your head around is the desperation inside the marketplace. And that desperation, of course, is what? The desperation has to do with a rumor comes into place that the Puerto Rican bonds, we get a partial payoff, and then that partial payoff ends up being $600,000 versus the $58 million that you need. So it's a big number. So here, this is just coming across too. Okay, Puerto Rico halted deposits into a fund that pays its general obligation bonds, and one of the agencies defaulted for the first time, marking an escalation of the island's fiscal crisis. Puerto Rican disclosed in a filing with the Municipal Securities Rulemaking Board Monday that it's temporarily suspended monthly payments into the fund that covers its $13 billion of general obligation debt. Okay, so now this is the next step, folks, okay? The announcement came after the Caribbean island paid $628,000 of what was due to the securities sold by the Public Finance Corporation because the legislation didn't provide enough money. Okay, so check this out. What they're saying now is this. This $5 billion in principal and interest due in the next 12 months. Now what has happened, this is just wild, man, is that the country itself has halted the deposits into the funds that pay the general obligation bonds. So this is a little bit different. And what's different is this, is that the bottom line is this is what it is. The agency that defaulted today, folks, okay, was not backed by the Puerto Rican, let's say the government. The general obligation bonds is backed by them. And bottom line, they're not going to be putting any more money into that because they don't want creditors to be able to go after it. So there's more problems coming down the pike. Always remember, whatever you think about, you bring about. Have a great one. Have a safe one. Look forward to speaking it right here tomorrow. Bam! Go get them, folks.